my aged Uncle Arly, sitting on a heap of barley through the silent hours of night. Close beside a leafy thicket, on his nose there was a cricket, in his hat a railway ticket, but his shoes were far too tight. Long ago in youth, he squandered all his goods away and wandered to the Tinniscoop hills afar. There, on golden sunsets blazing, every evening found him gazing, singing, "Orb, you're quite amazing. How I wonder what you are." Like the ancient Medes and Persians, always by his own exertion, he subsisted on those hills, whilst by teaching children spelling, or at times by merely yelling, or at intervals by selling Proctor's Nicodemus pill. Later, in his morning rambles, he perceived the moving bramble something square and white disclosed. 'Twas a first-class railway ticket, but on stooping down to pick it, off the ground, a pea-green cricket settled on my uncle's nose. Never, never more, oh, never did that cricket leave him ever. Dawn or evening, day or night, clinging with a constant pressure, chirping with a curious measure, wholly to my uncle's pleasure, though his shoes were far too tight. So for 43 winters, till his shoes were worn to splinters, all those hills he wandered o'er, sometimes silent, sometimes yelling, till he came to Borley Melling, near his old ancestral dwelling. But his shoes were far too tight. On a little heap of barley died my aged Uncle Arly, and they buried him one night close beside the leafy thicket. There his hat and railway ticket. There his ever faithful cricket. But his shoes were far too tight.